ended now. I can't forget the night we met. It seemed the same to me. So take me back to the badlands of Oregon. Here's my home again. Dusty wonders why. So take me back to the badlands of Oregon. Well, I'm leaving now. This is
white and grey, and then begin another timeless day. 5 o'clock in the morning, while dream-seeking children sleep, and we two stare at an eyelid world like swimming energy. All lights out, who turned them out? Everybody has said that by 5 o'clock in the morning you should be in bed. Cold and bored and tired, our fingers numb, unseeing eyes can see the milkman come. 5:30 in the morning, the mist is rolling on the ground, and we two walk along a lamplit street with unhearing ears full of sound. Can that be rain? Or are we deaf again? Everybody has said that by 5 o'clock in the morning you should be in bed. Rain and mist and drizzle are shrouding our lives. Serenity soothes, extracting its time. 6 o'clock in the morning, the coffee's cold, the players are done, and with eyelids heavy from a peaceful eve, we look into the first rays of sun. Is that a beam slanting unseen? And it's true what everyone has said, that by 5 o'clock in the morning you should be in bed.
I'm gonna buy you a ticket at the station, baby. Don't you know how I'm really gonna go on that train? On that train.
Regency days.
It was then that every young man, by foul means or by fair, tried to win the lady who rode through Cavendish Square. But Lady De Harcourt went riding with a military gentleman, handsome and devil may care. Perhaps she's unique in a desperate intrigue with a dark cavalier. The ladies, they were muslin, and the lord's coat super fine, and sword and answer to every quarrel of the time. Beau Brummel was in fashion with his boots of champagne shine. He dined at White's but tasted life, only in the end to find that lady had loved him with a love that never could have been. Oh, she had never been free to love him the way when together they lay in those Regency days.
Was it all a strange game? You're a little insane.
marshes in the pale grey light of dawn. Far below, down among the rushes, waits the trapper, cold and all alone. While he's waiting there, there is no sign of movement in the still quiet of the air. He shivers coldly within a skin of caribou, with the hoar frost matted in his hair. In this world of ours, hardship's just a dream. Can't we understand the life for him must seem? Cause if he doesn't shoot but straight, there's only death to be his fate. He must eat his food with speed, or else it freezes to his plate. It's 40 below. Day by day, he wanders through the pine trees, with the cold air burning in his lungs. He can only hope that his sense of fear doesn't signify that all the traps have sprung. In this world of ours, hardship's just a dream. Can't we understand the life for him must seem? Cause if he doesn't shoot but straight, there's only death to be his fate. He must eat his food with speed, or else it freezes to his plate. It's 40 below. While geese are flying across the frozen wasteland, moving onwards towards the rising sun, there lies a trapper down among the rushes, with his fingers frozen to his gun. She'll be lying in bed. I wonder where her thoughts will roam. Her ribs are all skinny, but then so mine. She used to say if we married, we'd have a very skinny child. I miss her now, and I'm wondering how, or if we'll ever meet again. I stand on the brink of the pit of the wandering dead. I was driving too fast, my luck was too good to last. The whiskey was singing in my head. Around the bend I went out of control, crippled my best friend as well as my soul. Well, here I stand, and if you ever can, never help me from the fate that I deserve. Now it is dawn, the trip is like spawn, will grow up all over the beach. Laughing and shouting, the radio's blaring, but
I shall be out of their reach, working my way through another long day, toothache and sorrow, there's no